Alright, what up? There really are a lot of Susanos, huh? I'm just now starting to play online. I think I've played more Susanos lately than anything else. God, I'm not ready for this. My Tager's not ready for anything. Oh god, that's such an ugly color. Yellow and blue, it just doesn't fucking go together, man. Blue is not a good connection. Oh, it's not a good connection! I actually blocked that, but it did. Oh my god, what? Oh my god, I hit that way too early. This dude knows he's in lag. Come on, fucking armor? Help a brother out. That was supposed to be 720. I can't do it in this. Why? Okay, so I need to recognize this dude's mashing on every single wake up. Wow, he tried to... Alright, that's a low. And that's vulnerable to lows. Fuck, I didn't mean to do that! He could have actually burst it. If he had been mashing burst that entire time, he totally could have gotten it. I don't know why. There was no reason for me not to do 6C Magnatech wheel there. And that would have prevented, obviously, the burst. Please don't come back. Not to be rude, but that was not a fun connection. Why? And I'm not mean enough to just be like, dude, fuck off. I'll give him a 2 out of 3, and then I will be like, please no. You got 2. Not in this connection again. Please select your character. God save me. I actually need to, I need to figure out exactly how much minimum damage his, 360B, 360B does, because it's you can actually, if you do it immediately, like, you have to do it, it's probably, like, within one or two frames of rapid canceling gadget finger, you can combo into, off of gadget finger rapid cancel, you can combo into 360B, and if you do the 360B follow-up to that, it's 100% burst safe, so I should find out exactly how much the minimum damage for that is, because having, you know, a burst safe ender like that is obviously very, very nice. Shouldn't do that. Need to learn. That was stupid of me. Stupid of me. That was probably a burst attempt, if I had to guess. I need to stop gadget fingering, I gotta stop doing it completely. What?! Damn, that 5A mashing? Yeah, this dude's just mashing buttons. Like, legitimately just mashing buttons. Fuck that up. He might have, because he got to cancel. I wonder if he could have actually done Because I think he went into... He might have gone into 2A. It might have been 2B. I'm not sure which. Oh, hell yes. We're going for the 3 bar. Get me out of here. We're going for the 3 bar. He might have been able to cancel that into... What's it called? Fuck. Exceed Excel. And that might have beaten Magnetech. I mean, Magnetech Wheel has... okay. Nope, that's worse. That's worse! But Magnetech Wheel has a lot of invincibility to it, so I'm not sure if it would have... I don't know if it would have won or not, but it was certainly a better chance than 2A or 2B, whichever move came out right there. This is actually probably a bad idea to be trying to clean my stick buttons when we're in the middle of this. Alright, this is just gonna suck. Yep, this is just gonna suck. Nice sledge, Nate. What?! Holy shit! Yo, this dude's fucking me up! Fuck my life with that poke! Yeah, that's safe, I can't do it. I don't know why you wouldn't continue pressure there. This is a good character. I'm an idiot. I'm a fucking idiot. I am such a fucking moron. What did I try to do there? I did 623D, thinking I needed a gadget finger whiff here. That was stupid. Cool! Fuck, I just teched with AC. I hit AC, like I did react to that. Damn it. Jesus Christ. This sucks. Oh, I'm an idiot. Thank God that worked. Because, like, I mean, come on. Who isn't fucking petrified of 720C after either Exceed Excel or 720 after a Tager just ran out of fucking nowhere, throws out Overdrive, right? Thank God that worked. That was such a fucking panic move. If only I knew how to do these things. Wait, did he just... That was... I'm so deflated now. Like, that was a good match, wasn't it? That felt like a good match. It felt like a good time. And then dude just fucking runs? Shit. Okay, well, we're going in blind here because I can guarantee you this is not a 4-bar connection. I've had a 4-bar connection with one person in my entire life. And that was Mr. Mystic D, who was chilling at the University of Santa Clara, had that godlike university internet. You know, I'd probably, because I believe San Jose and San Francisco both have Google Fiber now. I bet I would have a 4-bar connection with somebody who had Google Fiber. But I don't know if anybody does. Oh, dear Lord. They don't like them, the intros. Uh-oh. We made some mistakes, guys. This is why you don't go in blind. Oh, God! There's got to be at least... Pfft. That was a hit confirmed, by the way. God help us all. What? Okay, so I have a question, actually. Tager players, help me out. This is a terrible idea. Okay. I'm just gonna do it, because they've just been doing shit all day, yeah. Is B-Sledge no longer projectile invincible? Does it only have the armor now? Because I feel like I've been getting beaten by projectiles. Okay, that was cool. That does work in not lag conditions. Why did I do that? I guess that's why. Why did I do that? I'm hitting buttons so fucking early right now, you have no idea. Cool! That was an attempted 720 that I only did a 360 for. Like, that wasn't even like, oh man, oh damn it. Damn. I gave it my best shot. I gave it my best shot. Oh boy. But yeah, so in like my, because I can't imagine her spear throw is just considered a normal, right? Like that wouldn't just, that has to be considered a projectile. She's throwing a fucking projectile. How could it not be? But it beat B-Sledge clean, went straight through it and counter hit it. And I can only imagine that would happen with, if it was only armor and not, it doesn't have projectile invulnerability anymore, you know? And I feel like I've seen that a few times where, like, I've been beaten by a projectile and it was kind of like, I don't know about that. I need to find... That dude was two bar. Oh, yeah, that's right. We did see two bars. It did not feel like it. So I guess two bar really is. Because it used to be that two bar was very much like... I think that's the dude that's over there, so let's pay attention and see what he is. Two bars used to be very much... Okay. Used to be very much in the advantage of good. It used to be very good. But now it feels like they're more bad than good. I mean, obviously I don't have, like I mentioned before, I do not have a significant sample size to be able to definitively say, yep, two bar connections, just utter trash. I'm speaking from a point of having played in like 10 of them and 7 of them were bad or something like that. All right, let's go. Everybody says Ragna's shit, so let's see. We'll find out firsthand. Oh, this is three bars. Oh, I'm happily gonna skip this part because this is a real three bars. Yay! Help! You can't start with Ragna's round start options. That! Tech that so late. I mean, at least I am trying to reaction tech them, right? Like, that's a good the fuck. It's cool that you can just low profile that for free. It's really awesome. That was stupid of me to hit a button there. Come on with this! Wow, called me the fuck out. I mean, that's kind of been, like, this entire match so far, is this dude's just been calling me the fuck out. I can't... I'm such a fucking idiot. Damn it, I need to stop hitting. Okay, so when he does that. I tried to 2A that. I tried to call it out, but 2A didn't even start to come out because I didn't get counter hit or anything. I should have known. Stupid of me to not expect that. What? 2A is such a good move. God damn it, I'm such an idiot. Shh. Should have rapid canceled that. Yeah, should have expected that.
What? That was not what I wanted!
Cool.
Shit.
That cross, that's what happened. Okay. I'll explain that in a second. Nice. Nice. Why do I keep pressing 5C there? Nice! I'm a fucking fraud! I've stopped trying to react to things, and I'm trying to call them out now, and it's not working for me. Oh god, I'm an idiot. Okay, this connection just went to shit. We're back? We're back? I teched that one late. I know I teched that one late. God damn it. I don't know what to do with Tager against anybody that isn't just reckless and neutral. I mean, a large part of that was that I kept, like, what, three times I got hit by the same frame trap 5C into fucking... What's it called? Hi, Mr. Blaze Guy! 5C into Dead Spike. But like, that's actually, well, I was gonna say that's free sledge bait. If he keeps doing that, I can start reacting to it with sledge. But obviously, if he stops doing that, then I can't do it anymore. It is a guess. It is a call out. But if it's not projectile invincible anymore, and instead, I mean, not projectile, if it's, yeah, projectile invincible, and if it's only an armor point, that probably won't work, which is a fun prospect. Oh, I hear you saying shit on the microphone, but I don't know what you're saying. Damn it. Okay, yeah, stupid of me to hit a button. That was safe, because he didn't instant block it, but I shouldn't have hit a button. It's not positive. Oh, I didn't know. That was a long time. And it didn't feel like it was that long. What? 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 Yeah, you need to be able to instant block with Tager, and I don't. And that's a huge problem against characters like Ragna who have such good pressure. Fuck! So stupid of me to get hit by that. I should have waited for him to land. Like, I'm pretty sure that still gives me plenty of time to punish. God, I love this character. I'm not sure why I got Fable Barrier. Like, Barrier was out, right? So, like, did it... I don't know. I can't instant block for the light. Like, I tried to instant block, it fucked up. I did old 360 attempts. I did old 360 attempts. I tried to do the quickness, I only went to the corner, and I got 5B instead. 360B, the invincibility was enough that it totally would have dodged that. So that dude's kicking my ass, let me say. Like, GG's and shit. Fuck you! I think I'm just gonna have to run. Yeah. Yeah. Flee in terror. Flee in embarrassment. I got bodied. I've never felt lost with Tager before. But I really do now. I legitimately don't know what to do with this character. And like I mentioned, a large part of that is that I need to instant block. Oh, so, that early, the first match when I, like, barely won that shit, I got lucky. where I got the 360B where he crossed me up. The reason why I actually got that 360B is because I had done, I was doing the motion for Magnatech Wheel. And so I did 236, 236, but in the middle of it, he actually crossed me up. And so it interpreted that as an entire circle instead, and thus got me a 360B. Shit, this isn't a good look. Ranked, here we come! Let's go fuck up our win percentage even more. No, this isn't gonna work. I'm always a little tricked, too, because it feels like, you know, if it came up that fast, shouldn't it mean we have a good connection because it happened so quickly? I want to get to level 30, dog. That's never... No! How do I have... See, like, look, my parameters are set. 3 or above. That's the second time somebody is just randomly, like, showing up and been like, hey, check out this 0 bar, motherfucker. How does that happen when I have my shit set to 3 bars only? I don't get it. Oh, boy. This is saddening. If it's still just showing me nothing but... Oh! Let's go lose our yellow fucking ranking thing. Because we're playing Tager. It's okay. Okidine's probably the best player in this room. Maybe not, because there actually are... Because Dark Blue is the worst, right? And there were people back in Chrono Phantasma. They intentionally knocked themselves down to, like, the lowest possible color just for shits and giggles. And, they, like, most of the people that had Dark Blue were actually the best players because you had to pretty much intentionally get yourself there. And so it was people that were kind of, like, trolling around, making people think they were going to be a free win, and then they end up bodying them. And so, like, I actually kind of tried to find those people because, again, they generally wound up being a lot more reliable, that those were good players versus, you know, anything like the oranges and the reds. It's kind of a crapshoot. It's not always a guarantee that they're good players. But it is, at the very beginning stages, it's definitely possible because the vast majority of people got placed into light green. And so they were all trying to claw their way out. And so a bunch of those people that, you know, didn't manage to claw their way out got beaten by the people that did, got knocked down to dark green, and then there's so many dark greens roaming around that it's perfectly reasonable to expect that some people would have been even knocked down from there to the light blue. But I think this is actually the first light blue I've seen, so if I see a dark blue, I know that person intentionally put themselves there. Or maybe this is the only light blue person in the world and they're just waiting for somebody else to be light blue and being like, hey, come knock me down to dark blue. Who knows? Where am I, actually? Oh, I'm just right on top of this dude. Let's go hang out with my buddy Jubei. He's my dude. He's my non-playable dude. But yeah, it really is. Like, the more I play Tager, the more I just feel like, let's just drop him, focus on Azrael and Susanoo, and then add in Hakumen later, and then we can see where life takes us after that. Because those are definitely, like, my top three characters that I want to learn right now. And then, you know, I've always, you know, listed out the other ones after that. And I'd like to look into them. Because, like, right now, there are no Taukakas. Zero. And... You know, it'd be nice to be that one dude that's just bodying everybody with Tao, right? Like, it's kind of fun to be that one person who's playing the character nobody expects to fight and is super good with them, too. And, like, that'll never happen with Azrael. That'll never happen with Susanoo. But characters like, for instance, Taukaka. Rachel's another one that's very rare. Carl could pick him back up. New is actually very rare. The Murakumos in general are very rare. But I think... Because I believe Lambda is considered the best of them. And then... A bullet? Okay, maybe if they're a bullet player, maybe they do deserve that light blue square. Sorry, bullet lovers! She done got fucked! Oh, only 13 matches. But yeah, like, I should have stared longer at the character select screen. Bullet is even one of them, really. Nobody's playing her because everybody thinks she sucks, and she actually does. She's one of the few people that I completely and utterly agree with the fact that she's just not a good character. I don't agree with the people who say Kagero is bad. I understand why they say he's bad, but I don't think he is actually bad. I don't think he's a great character by any means, but a lot of people consider him, like, unplayably bad, and I don't agree with that at all. Noelle, I might agree with. Like, those are the three. Everybody says, like, Noelle, Bullet, Kagero. Bottom three in the game, for sure. I agree with Bullet. Tentatively, I agree with Noelle, but I don't know enough about that character. I just know that there were always a decent amount of Japanese Noelles playing, and those are all gone. Nobody plays Noelle there anymore. And even then, like, I still see a couple Bullets here and there. Upa is the most prolific and is actually in, like, Hades rank or whatever, like the yellow icon thing. Where they don't have a numbered rank anymore, they have, like, an actual title. And I see a couple Kagaras here and there, but I don't see Noelle ever. I should just one day drop the argument that S and Mai are terrible too, because you never see them in Japanese tournaments. See if people actually try to argue the point, or if they're just like, you fucking idiot, they're not in an arcade yet. And that's where they play all their tournaments. Those are my internet arguments that I actually enjoy. I don't want to try to have a legitimate argument with people, because most people that argue in this isn't just an internet thing, although it is very prolific on the internet, but most people that have arguments in general, they're not looking to have their viewpoints tested. They're not looking to have their information tested. They're looking to prove you wrong through any means necessary, and they have no intention whatsoever of changing their opinion, regardless of what you present to them, facts or not. And so I don't even generally engage. I do that absurd shit. Did that just pass both of them? No, Okidine disappeared. Okidine is just gone. Like, I came back here about as fast as it was possible to come back. Please don't tell me you're saying bye-bye to me. You know, this is the fourth time in a row. I'm not shitting you. This is the fourth time in a row I have come up for a match with another yellow squared person and been kicked. I mean, I don't think that was kicked. I believe the person actually did. Like, let me just check. I'm pretty sure they just straight up disbanded the lobby. Because it was the Mobius person that was. So it looks like they straight up disbanded the lobby. And I don't think this was the case. Because they did have another yellow square person in there, so they've probably been playing them this entire time. But, like, it's really hard to not kind of see that happen and kind of think, like, does this person really care that much about the yellow square that they're gonna dodge? And again, like, I don't think that was the case because there was another yellow person in there, but, like, the person four times before this ran into them and ranked, 3-bar connections, immediately left. Like, didn't even try to play me, didn't even stick around to kind of, like, let the connection... If they hadn't seen the connection yet, they just immediately left. Even though, again, 3-bar connection, which is ideal if you're trying to play ranked, just disappeared. And so then I tried to play in a lobby, and the host was yellow, and everybody else in the lobby was either unranked, dark green or light green. There's nobody else in the lobby. And I sat there, and then eventually it came back around. You know, they finished the match, they came out of it, immediately kicked. It wasn't even like, oh yeah, I played this person, the connection was shit, let's not even deal with that, get rid of them. Just immediately kicked me the second the match was over. And then the third one was a person playing, again, in another lobby where there were a lot of people. It was a full lobby, 8-person lobby. And they went through the gauntlet. Like, I think they played 6 matches before it finally got around to me. And again, all unranked, dark green, light green players. The minute it got to me, They passed their turn and left the lobby. And then this happens. And it's hard not to think these people are just dodging the yellow. Which is so fucking silly. And like, it's why I hate this type of system. Because people do actually put stuck. Like, I could not care less if I got knocked down to green, and then I got knocked down to dark green, and then I got my ass bodied down to light blue, and then killed down to dark blue, God forbid. I might care at that point. That's a lot of losses to eat. But you've seen, like, I've done basically 4 videos. You haven't seen 2 of them because those were the 2 that I lost. 4 videos of majority losses with Tager, and I hold every single one of them, and I'm fine with it, and I don't care. But the fact that it's costing me matches against people, that it's wasting time, because I at least 1 or 2 of those 4 people that dodged definitely did it because they didn't want their yellow, they didn't want to risk their yellow. And it's just so frustrating that something like this is costing me time, is causing people to dodge each other, is causing people to manipulate it, and that is what will always happen when you have any kind of ranking system. People are going to do what they can to manipulate the numbers and make it look as favorable as possible to them because they care for some reason about that, even though anybody can, like, play them and see, like, your numbers do not actually reflect the quality of your gameplay. And that's what I mentioned, like, if I had to rank my characters, my Azreal right now is an orange, my Susanoo is a light green, my Tager is a dark blue. I try to be as honest as possible about the quality of my characters and what I need to improve on, and sometimes my actual statistics do not reflect that in one way or another, whether it's because I have been playing against people that were not on the same level as me, and so I got wins that I really maybe shouldn't have against somebody of, like, that's considered similar quality to me but really wasn't, because it was just, you know, their statistics looked similar on paper, that kind of thing. Anyway, I'm being way too preachy right now, but it just sucks that, you know, you sit around, you wait, you hope for a match, it gets to your turn, and then you just get backhanded out the room, likely because that person doesn't want to play another person that has the same color as them, because they're not confident in their own capabilities. And for some reason, that color means something to them. For whatever reason. Like, I'm not going to take it away. If you do, like, respect this system, and it does give you some sort of pride to have a high rank in it, do you. Everybody has a different opinion. And I'm not saying you're a shitty person if you do take stock in it, but the fact that people do put so much stock in it that it causes them to dodge is just beyond frustrating. And it's happened since Chrono Phantasma, and it'll just keep happening as long as a system like this is in place. Alright, well, that's it for me, because as you can see, that's a bunch of 0 and 1s, and I don't play in binary fields, so I'm out. Peace!